Yeah, I heard the old mate tell me a while ago, he's 70 odd now, but he said they used to come out here when they were young fellas skiing. That was way back. Cage it off so you can't get in there now, but there's a emu foot carved in a rock and a pair of roo feet carved in the rock.
I got 10 that work. Only on my back.
Yeah, no. You almost elbowed me in the face.
Thank you. Also, last one, you can't pump during some seasons. Limited pumping.
So your wife might go for a stroll down south side while you sleep.
I don't know which season.
So where's your wife at now? Like, probably at home.
First aid kit have no Panadol.
They don't. No medicines and first aid kits anymore. Not allowed.
Oh, exactly.
You're
still
a
You can see the damage that it's done to the place that we once managed, controlled, and used the right way by Aboriginal people. And today, for me to talk about how we can manage that and how we can get Boobera Lagoon back to its natural state. If you look across the other side here, you can see what damage water scheme, chemical, access by cattle, sheep, have put on that area. So today, after I finish talking to you, I've got a meeting here with the owner of the property to talk about the fencing of Boobera. The trees on both sides are called riparian zones. That's where the water filters. These trees, filter the water, purifies. But if you ever look how far the water is away from those trees, you can't do that because of the impact caused by whitewash, by boats, and other activities.
I'll go up here in the morning.
So my job is to make sure that those areas are restored. Rehabilitated back to its normal state. And by doing that, we've got to say, well, cattle or sheep can't go anywhere. So they're made. People who've been doing some courses around environmental management, whether it be